Southeast Asia is an area with age-old seafaring and fishing traditions. Aquatic resources and the fruits of the sea have earned significant income for the countries of the region. Fishing boats have sailed the seas and caught fish for the people ashore for hundreds of years. These fishing boats appear to be similar, but if we look more closely, we see differences in respect of the place they come from and the type of fishing gear they use. The Philippines archipelago is formed from over 7,100 islands, and many people make their living from fishing. The design of Philippines fishing boats are totally different from those of Thailand or Malaysia. The geographical location of the Philippines has strong winds and heavy seas. Fishing boat shapes and constructions have evolved over many hundreds of years to safely work in these conditions. The registered number is painted on both sides of the bows and gives the Coast Guard Division province of registration, license number, and the year of first registration. Sometimes the name of the home port is painted on the stern. Throughout the Philippines, there are many types of fishing boats, both licensed and unlicensed. There are bankers, sailing boats, motor boats, and many other types of watercraft used for fishing activities. The fishing boats can be classified into two main types: municipal and commercial fishing boats. The municipal fishing boats are usually built of wood and have a displacement less than 3 tons. The methods of propulsion may be motor, sail, or paddles. These small-scale fishing boats operate in the coastal waters. Most of the municipal fishing boats have outriggers for stability and are called bankers, meaning small boats. Boats without the outriggers or with a single sponson are used as service tenders, as they can be put alongside other boats more easily. The outrigger is usually a wooden structure held in place by two or more transverse beams, depending on the size of the boat. The frame formed by the transverse beams is closed by the outriggers, one at either side. The front of the outriggers are usually constructed with a sharp upward curve to reduce drag and so increase speed when moving in the water. The fishing gear used in an outrigger banker are changeable in accordance with the season, area, and whichever type of fish is most abundant. The gear used may be fish traps, push nets, baby trawl, trolling line, and so on. However, the main fishing gear types are gill net, hand line, and long line. When talking about the Philippines fishing boats, we mostly refer to the small-scale boats because they are by far the most common. Style and color vary according to area. We can classify small-scale boats according to the style and construction. The dugout is the simplest form of banker, hewn from a single log. These range in length from 3 to as much as 15 meters. Most of the Philippine dugout canoes are equipped with motors and are known locally as motron, or pump boats. The smaller dugouts are used in fish ponds and lakes. The medium sizes are used with fishing gear like hook and line, gill nets, and other small equipment. The dugout is also sometimes used as the keel and garboards of other types of banker. From the sides of the dugout, fishermen will make frames and fasten planking to form the hull of the banker. The Big U is a type of banker that can only accommodate a single person. The bow and stern are quite long, and the top of the banker is covered in at where the fisherman sits, a little like an Eskimo kayak. They are usually black in colour and are driven by paddle, or sometimes a small sail. A tango is usually seen in the Visayas and Mindanao, the central part and south of the Philippines. The bows and stern are short and protrude at the ends. Two or three fishermen can be accommodated in this type of boat. A launch is a carved bottom banker. There is no dugout used as a keel. It is about 7 meters long and is powered by an outboard motor. The normal fishing gear used on these boats is the drift filter net. Flat V-type and flat V-type combinations are types of launch, the difference being in the shape of the bottom and hull. These boats are mostly found in the northern part of the country around Luzon. The bow is pointed while the stern is broad. This design is more suitable for the rough seas found in the area. A Pinapak Lawin banker is similar to the tango, except that the ends of the outrigger frames are joined with tree branch outriggers, forming a 70 degree angle where the outriggers are attached, hence the name Pinapak Lawin, meaning hawk's wings. This type is very popular in the central part of Luzon. It is sometimes motorized and used for hand lining, trolling, hook and line fishing, and gill netting. Tuna fishing is quite popular in the Philippines, particularly in the south. The tuna boats vary in shape and size, both for municipal and commercial activity. The fishing gear used for catching tuna are mainly trolling line, hand line, and drift gill nets. Generally, the characteristics of small-scale tuna boats are similar. The tuna grounds are quite far offshore, and there is a protective shield, usually made from plywood and often colorfully painted. It is there to protect the fishermen from the waves and the strong wind. The leading end of the outriggers are shaped to reduce drag in the water and allow an increased speed while moving in the water. The commercial fishing boats are licensed and range upwards from 3 tons. They are used in commercial fishing activities like purse seining, trawling, bag netting, and long lining. These are generally motorized and operate well offshore from about 15 to 200 miles out into the economic exclusive zone. There are two types of commercial boats. Some are wooden and the others of steel construction. These are imported from Taiwan or Japan and are called Chinese sampans. The classification of commercial fishing boats is dependent upon the fishing gear used. Ringneck fishing boats are usually made of wood and range from 15 to 50 gross tons. The pilot house is located at mid-deck with the fish hold under the foredeck. The fishing gear is handled from the stern to make net operation easier. The light boat is a V-bow flat bottom boat of less than 3 gross tons. Some are motrans without riggers. The tuna longline boats are V-shaped, ranging from 20 to more than 150 gross tons, and measure from 16 to 30 meters overall. They may be of wood, fiberglass, or steel. Most come from Taiwan and have a very deep draft to accommodate the catch of tuna. The low foredeck is wide to easily hold the fishing gear. The fish holds are close to where the catch is brought aboard. The boats have a capacity for fuel, fresh water, and ice enough for a fishing trip of 2 months. There are three types of purse seiners, having one or two masts. Others have been converted from other types of vessel. The one-masted type include all the locally constructed purse seiners and converted trawlers. They have a pilot house forward, leaving the after deck free for the net platform and working area. The mast and boom are aft of the pilot house, allowing all the net hauling and shooting to be carried out easily. The two-masted type of purse seiners include all the war reparation vessels and imported second-hand purse seiners. The pilot house is often located at mid-deck or slightly aft of foredeck. They have a mast and boom for power blocks and a separate king post for ring lifting and fish brailing located forward of the pilot house. The converted vessels were formerly trawlers. The wooden trawling platform aft has been removed at the back of the pilot house and a fixed net platform constructed at the stern. Two carrier boats are used to service the purse seiner and are used to ferry the catch ashore and carry supplies back to the fishing grounds. They are also used to assist the purse seiner with lure lighting. Sometimes the purse seine boats will use sonar boats and light boats to assist the operation. In the Philippines, there are three types of trawler: the baby trawler, the medium, and the commercial trawler. The baby trawler is a banker type vessel with bamboo outriggers. It has a bamboo boom in the middle for fastening the sweep lines after the trawl net has been paid out. It is usually manned by two or three fishermen. The medium-sized trawler is wooden and they range from 3 to about 50 gross tons. The third type is the commercial trawler, made of steel or wood and displacing more than 50 gross tons. The steel-built trawlers are usually bought from Japan. The fish holds have capacities from 10 to 30 tons and can be away from port for more than a month. They have from 10 to 15 crew members. The Bassnig fishing boat is used for commercial fishing and uses the bag net. There are several sizes and designs according to the fishing area. In the Sulu archipelago, the Bassnig is operating in conjunction with two small dugouts. As you can see, the fishing boats of the Philippines are mainly small scale, unique and beautiful. The banker with outriggers are the most common throughout all the islands. Operation. Demonstration lang po. Papapalangin na.